Hi, I'm Yuko Suge and I'm pianist. Today I'm going to play a recital in this hall. It's the last concert of my Four Elements series. This time the theme is Earth. The theme Earth today, I associated with lots of characters of Earth, from forest and nature to life's own struggle, life and death. Because death, in Japan we say you go back to Earth about dying. And last but not least, the theme homeland means a lot to me.
Thank you.
When I think about my own life, I was born in Tokyo, and I moved to Germany when I was 10 years old. Since then, I was performing in concerts. Recently, I'm going back and forth between Japan and Germany. From my Japanese influences, the pose in music, it's very important in Eastern culture. I think the silence, also distance in Japanese gardens or shrine or temples, the distance between the stones, it's also in music. In music, between the notes, there's always the pose, which is also music. When you come and start playing, the silence before, it just means also a lot. And I think this is something very special when what I bring from Japan.
Thank you.
today's program, it has lots of masterpieces of piano music from Beethoven, Schubert, masters of Viennese classic, Czech composer Janáček, and Chopin. But I also put work by Dai Fujikura, who is a good friend of mine in the same generation. And his piece is called Akiko's Diary. This piece is the cadenza part of his new piano concerto called Akiko's Piano. It has a very extraordinary story behind it. Akiko was a girl. She was born in LA in America. She moved to Japan when she was 7 years old. She enjoyed to play the piano, and she brought back her upright piano from LA. She went to lessons and continued to enjoy playing. When she was 19, the atomic bomb was dropped in Hiroshima. And she was not badly injured, but she went home to her parents' house by walking, and she had to swim where the bridge was broken. And she died in the next day from the radiation. Dai's piece was composed on this special piano, which has survived the atomic bomb, and parts of glass, broken glass, is in the piano too. This piano has a very special warm sound, and also, almost metallic, a little bit glass or light kind of upper part. And he composed such a beautiful music from the view of this innocent girl. And when you hear it, you feel also all this pain, but also the beauty of life. as you see, the auditorium has a pyramid kind of ceiling. And I think this is very special because the pyramid is also Eastern culture, but also it feels like the high ceiling of a church. And when I play here, I always feel like I'm playing in a concert hall, but also in a church. And the interior of this hall consists completely from oak. And this makes the hall has wonderful acoustic.
Thank you.